Chrissy, this is something I know that you mentioned during your consultation. I know that you also had some concerns about your skin texture and hyperpigmentation from time in the sun as well, but you also mentioned you had some concerns about your lips. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
My concern, I know it's just, you know, the trend that's going on, and it's definitely not one of the things that I do want to go and follow. You know, certain celebrities are getting the more enhanced look, and it's a little, you know, extreme. I'm more interested in a natural enhancement. You know, over time, you do notice that there's certain, you know, asymmetry going on, and I would really like to address that.
So, Jenny, how common is this among patients that you're seeing today?
So it's really, really popular now, as you all know, because of Instagram and because of different filters and because of the selfies. Now everyone's looking at every angle of their face in every different lighting, in every, you know, angle possible. So they'll notice something about their cheeks, about their lips. Oh, I notice now, like, this side's bigger than this side. But really, we're not even. We are all, like, you know, we're not even. So if you're like, okay, this doesn't match that side and this. So when you notice those things, we can fix them with the filler. So a lot of patients are coming in because they want their top lip or their bottom lip just a bit more plump, or like one side of their Cupid's bow isn't as sharp as the other one, and we can definitely fix those areas. We also want to make sure everyone looks natural, so we don't go overboard. We just want to make sure that you still look like yourself, but just an enhanced version. We don't want you to look like somebody totally different. We just want you to look refreshed. We just want someone to look at you and not really know what you did, but you just look like you came back from vacation or had a good nap or something. You know, you just look refreshed and like your skin's like nice and plump after a nap. So we just want to make everyone look nice and fresh, totally youthful, like them. We want to preserve your beauty. We don't want to make you look tired. We don't want to make you feel like, oh my God, this girl always looks tired, but she's not tired. Like, the worst compliment you could ever get is someone saying that you always look tired when you're not. So that's why we do the under eye filler. That's why we plump up the lips a bit. We make you look like you, like how you were 5 years ago, not 20 years ago. We always, always want everyone to look natural here. We don't do the overboard, like, you know, we're not going to give you somebody else's lips. We're going to make your lips look amazing and youthful.
The lips are probably the thing that people are afraid of the most, because they don't want to look like, you know, the awful wives of
Lisa Rinna, duck lip.
Yeah. So the reason that happens is because everyone's afraid to say no to a patient, right? And one of the things we've talked about with all the nurses is, you know, don't be afraid to say no. Like, just say, this is what I think you need, because lip aesthetics are very complicated. So it's not about giving someone a fat lip. It's about getting better definition of the Cupid's bow, getting a vermilion border. Have you ever seen a baby? They have this little roll along the edge of their red lip. That's called the vermilion border. We're trying to adjust the relationship between the upper lip and the lower lip, which fits the golden mean, 1.16 to 1. We're trying to arrange those things. And then when you look at someone who's had a really good lip, you just say, when they put their lipstick on, that lip is beautiful. It's not fat, it's not thick, it just has a beautiful shape. Those little lines in the red lip, those little lines in the white lip, we're trying to fix those little things. And if no one can tell that you've had it done, then it's really good.